Oh yes. Mr. Wonderful has made his return to the FC Sneaker Factory for another brand new episode for you beautiful people out there. The fellas and those beautiful ladies, oh, that I call my cheerleaders. Oh, beautiful ladies, since we're in the month of February, oh, you know I appreciate each and every single one of you. Oh, especially if you're looking so damn beautiful from head to toe. From that beautiful face with that nice clean skin to that amazing hair that the majority of you have. But look at Mr. Wonderful. Like I just mentioned in the past video, that beautiful light. Oh, that beautiful light is coming through the FC Sneaker Factory window upon myself. Of course, I'm looking amazing for you beautiful people out there, the fellas and those beautiful ladies. But also looking beautiful for myself, looking amazing for myself, because you know what? I have respect for myself as far as how I look and how I'm viewed upon you people out there. Even when I just go to the grocery store, I look amazing. And I feel like you should all do that. I know if you're married, you're married. There's nothing wrong with that. But you should still always look amazing for your loved one, whether you're just lounging at home, whether you're actually out and about running errands with your loved one. But if you're single, oh God, you fucking better be looking amazing at all times, because how in the world are you supposed to get a girl if you don't have any self-respect for yourself and want to look amazing when you're doing the simple things in life? You just never know who you're going to come across. So that's why I always say, look fucking amazing, so therefore you feel amazing. Therefore, you put out that amazing vibe so you can get some beautiful women. That's just some simple advice from Mr. Wonderful. But I am wearing a nice Lulu Fundamental long sleeve tee because it is cold out here in California. And it is like this nice, I want to say like a brick kind of color long sleeve. It's amazing though. It feels amazing. I mean, the skin tone, of course, it goes well with Mr. Wonderful. Look at that. Some nice page denim. Great denim. I love page denim. The Tag Aqua Racer right here and that beautiful blue dial to go with the denim. I know. You don't have to tell me. The skin, the hair, always looking amazing. The smile, of course, when I do smile for those women, when I come across them, you know, it always is pearly white and I always get compliments on my smile. I just don't flash it around all the time because I feel like not everybody deserves that. That's just my thinking. So, like I mentioned on the previous episode, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, people out there, the fellas and those ladies. I'm sorry. The cheerleaders, of course, I'm sorry. You're not getting any new content from me, but we are doing, or I should say I'm doing, some sneaker profile remixes. Just like how I touched on when it came to the Halloween shoes. Just like how I touched on when it came to the Christmas shoes. Well, since we're in that beautiful month of February, oh, Cupid's month, when it comes to Valentine's Day, when it comes to those beautiful ladies, I decided to do a sneaker profile remix on some profiles that I did from back in the day. But first, I dropped a live on February 10th, 2022. That was one of the few lives that I did when it came to my channel. I did a good amount of lives now that I think about it. But these were towards the beginning, towards the end of the lives when it comes to my channel. Didn't last very long doing lives because I just didn't see any traction when I was doing them. I had like maybe 5 people viewing them and I was like including myself. So very few in numbers, just like how I get, you know, my numbers are low when it comes to the profiles and when it comes to this channel. People don't give me the self-respect that I deserve. People don't understand what I'm fucking delivering them on an everyday basis, I should say. And people don't understand, like, that these are all my fucking sneakers, right? I don't get these free. I don't get these, you know, people lending them to me so I could do profiles on. No, these are all my sneakers. I've been in the fucking game for 20 plus years. Dropping knowledge as always. Didn't want to do, you know, back then I didn't even know YouTube was available to do any of this kind of stuff on. I just really just was collecting for my own, you know, my own self need. Never had a desire to share it with people. until, you know, just recently in what, the past 2 years ago, that's when I really decided to maybe do YouTube and really take it seriously. But you know what? I don't do it for the numbers. I mean, what numbers do I have to look forward to? I don't do it definitely for non-monetary value, because I get zero to zero for that. I do it because I love the fucking sneaker game. I love shoes. Big fan of shoes for 20 plus years. I do it because, you know what? I want to look back at myself when I'm trying to put together an outfit and I can see exactly what shoe I have, because I have so many damn shoes behind me. So that's why I do it. But I also do it for you people, because you know what? You deserve fucking a real sneakerhead giving you an amazing delivery, giving you a shoe that he loves, not just that I'm just trying to drop that early look on. I'm doing it because I love these shoes and I feel like you should love them as well, especially the shoes that are in the FC Sneaker Factory. So let's go on. So this sneaker profile right here, the one that I'm about to drop to you, is really sneaker profile 107. And I actually delivered that to you beautiful people back on December 7th of 2022. I got that one right this round. 2022 is when I dropped this one. Amazing shoe. A shoe that I feel like did not get the respect that it deserved when it when it retroed. I mean, I had this shoe when it originally came out. I didn't go buy it like when it first came out, but I picked it up years later. And I picked it up on StockX. I sold it before this shoe dropped, because thank God I did that, because I probably would have got, you know, way less than what I purchased. I made a small profit when it came to that one. And then obviously I picked the retro up. And based on the original, because I had the original and the retro in hand, the same shoe. So there's really nothing different about one or the other. It was literally the same shoe, which I was very grateful that Nike did, because it deserved that. It deserved to be identical, because, I mean, it's only right. If you're going to do a retro of the shoe, it should be pretty damn identical to the original. So let's go ahead and go on this one. The sneaker profile remix when it comes to this shoe right here. Let's take a look at the box and then we'll go into the shoe. But you see that? It's all blacked out box. Another great box, just like the Carmine colorway when it comes to this one. Another great box, a great solid box when it comes to this one. Let's take a look at that tag. Move out, move back in. See if I can move out again, move back in to get it clear. Yeah, it looks like it's not going to happen on this one. Let's see. Come on, one more. We'll do it one more time. There we go. Maybe we get it right there. Nah. But you could see it. The 10.5 Nike Air Max 90 NRG. I want to say it says sale, but I'm going to have to read it to you. It says sale, sheen, straw, medium brown. The price tag on this one, $140. But yeah, sorry about that. It's the camera sometimes. I don't understand it. But it is a pull-out box, so it's pretty cool on that. Kind of a bitch to be pulling this out all the time. But nice tissue paper. Besides that, nothing really going on in terms of the box. I mean, a little bit of special box, but I love that box. I love when it's a solid black box. But let's go ahead and go on to the shoe right here. Like I mentioned, this was sneaker profile 107. This was delivered back on December 17th of 2022. And this is just an amazing colorway when it comes to Valentine's. I feel like this is a great shoe to go to when it comes to February, when it comes to Valentine's Day, because of the colors. So that's why it's one of my Valentine's colorway shoes, Valentine's theme shoe. Just a great shoe. I still haven't worn this to this day. It's kind of sad because, you know what? I had the original and never wore that. Sold it on StockX. Bought this one. I actually got two of these shoes and I sold one of them on OfferUp. Made a small price, but just a shoe that did not get enough respect when it came to it being released. And this is Sneaker Profile Remix on the Nike Air Max 90 Bacons. This shoe right here was originally released back in 2004 and then re-released on Air Max Day for the model's 30th anniversary on March 26, 2021. Retail price tag was on this one was $140. The shoe was released in collaboration with now closed NYC sneaker boutique Dave's Quality Meat, designed to resemble the shades of a strip of bacon. The shoe features shades of red, pink, sail, constructed with that leather suede upper. This is widely regarded as one of the most iconic Air Max 90s ever. With all that said, amazing shoe to bring out for the month of February, because you have amazing colors. You have this nice beige color, this beautiful red, and a pink. And then also you even have the nice brown to resemble the chocolate. So let's go ahead and go into this shoe. But we all know this shoe is not made for Valentine's Day. This shoe is basically made to resemble the shades, the cuts of bacon right here. So let's take a look at this shoe. Nice leather when it comes to the toe box. It's not smooth. It does have like a texture going on to it. This right here, beautiful red synthetic suede right here on the toe box. And then it goes throughout the lateral part of the shoe. Love it. But you see all that nice lateral red hits when it comes to the synthetic suede right here. This nice brown rubber part when it comes to the shoelaces. And then also you have that same brown hit on the upper part of the shoe where the shoelaces are. But you see that this nice, you got that typical rubber, but you have that nice stripes going on. A beautiful pink swoosh right here. And then that is in leather. Right here is that same leather right here on the toe box, but you have it right here in that nice like sail color right here. Sail color suede, beautiful touch on that, but it is not a smooth suede, but of like a rough suede right there. Then Air Max in brown, and then you see that stripe rubber part right there that we typically get when it comes to Air Max and IDs right here. Love this though. That nice sail midsole, and then you got that nice transitioning into that brown sail midsole. You see the stripes, and then that pink air unit, but the outsole, that's actually all in brown as well. So let's take a look at the rear part. That typical rubber hit when we see that when it comes to Air Max 90s, it's all in brown, but inside you have that nice Nike swoosh and that air in that beautiful pink. Below that, you have that nice leather in that sail color, and then also that nice synthetic suede right here, just below that when it comes in that sail color. Sail midsole, and then you can see that nice brown outsole. So the medial part, our medial side, looks identical to the lateral side. Nothing's changed when it comes to that. You have all the same leather hits. You have that all same suede hits. You have all those same colors though when it comes to the medial side. Do you have that nice right here is that nice suede sail color hit right there. Beautiful red hit when it comes to that synthetic suede. The pink swoosh, the nice brown rubber hits going through the shoelaces, and then that same brown hit right here as well when it's going through the shoelace. Sail midsole, but that nice transition into that brown midsole as well. Pink air unit, Air Max, and then that same rubber hit when it comes to the medial side, and a nice brown Air Max. Gorgeous shoe. Let's take a look at the front part. Oh, I love the front part. You know what? Air Max 90s are amazing shoes. They look great. It's just like the Air Max one. They look great on with shorts. They look great with shoes. Just beautiful shoe. Easy to style. Look at that brown, completely chocolate brown outsole right here. Beautiful. Let's look at my favorite part. I love this. I love this, especially on this one. Look at that. Beautiful. Love it. The aerial view of the shoe right here, this nice leather when it comes to that toe box. You could see a little bit of texture going on. That red hit when it comes to that portion just below the tongue, but you do have that synthetic red suede. And of course, you can have that nice mesh tongue. You got the sail colored shoelaces, but the tongue is actually pink, but you also have that nice tag right here in brown. You even see that little sail stitching around it. The Nike, the swoosh, and the Air Max in all that beautiful red. Love the inside of this shoe. Look at that nice sail color insole, or I'm sorry, ankle collar, but the insole is, oh, look at that bloody red insole. that Nike Check and Air that is in that beautiful white color. Great shoe, though. I haven't seen this shoe in quite some time. Honestly, the last time I pulled this shoe out was when I did the profile way back on December 7th of 2022. So it's been a couple years since I've seen this shoe, since I pulled it out. Definitely want to get this one out. I always forget about it, to be honest with you. This is one of those shoes I always forget about, but I cannot forget about it. I need to bust this out because I feel like now it's a perfect time. February is a perfect time for this shoe right here. February, 2 years later is a perfect time because I doubt you see DS pairs when it comes to this one right here. Great shoe though. What do you think? Do you think this is a great shoe? And when it comes to February, when it comes to Valentine's Day, a perfect shoe to bring out? Do you think this is just a great shoe to bring out year round just because of the collaboration, the 2004 collaboration, Dave's Quality Meat? What do you think about this one? Is this one in your collection? Is this one, have you beat this to shit? Or is this a shoe that you just have not had a chance to wear just like myself? Drop a comment down below. What a gorgeous shoe. I love that shoe. A shoe you just don't really see very often anymore. But, of course, it is in the FC Sneaker Factory. Mr. Wonderful does have it in his presence. Does have it in his grace. And I want to bless you people out there with myself on camera with an amazing shoe. And, of course, those beautiful ladies, because this is the month of February. Hey, if you're beautiful, drop a comment down below. But drop a comment in or drop a message in IG. I would love to hear from each and every single one of you. You beautiful ladies out there and the fellas out there as well. I hope you're having an amazing February so far. Don't forget, celebrate it in the right way. Be safe when you're doing so. But you know what? This is the closure of Sneaker Profile Remix of an amazing shoe. To be honest with you, Sneaker Profile 107 back in the day, right? Back in the day, a long time ago, was when I delivered that one to you. But in a couple days, we'll do it all over again. I'll be delivering another Sneaker Profile Remix as we're inching closer and closer to Valentine's Day. I appreciate each and every one of you for stopping on by. You don't have to go home, but you have to get the hell out of the FC Sneaker Factory because I got to hurry up and wrap these all up. Got a beautiful date with one of those beautiful ladies. I appreciate you, though. Thank you for stopping by. Just like how I know at the end of this date what those words that I'm about to hear. Mr. Wonderful, Floyd, you are too. Damn.